The Good Egg by Jory John and Pete Oswald. Rescuing this cat. Know why? Because I'm a good egg. A very good egg. It's true. I do all kinds of good things, like I'll carry your groceries, I'll water your plants, I'll fix your tires, I'll paint your house. If you need any help whatsoever, I'm your egg. I've always been a good egg. It's been this way from the start, even in my earliest days, back at the store. There were a dozen of us living together under one recycled roof. There was Meg and Peg and Greg and Clegg and Shell and Shelly and Sheldon and Shelby and Egbert and Frank and
I don't want
other Frank. The other 11 eggs weren't on their best behavior. They weren't exactly good. They ignored their bedtime. They only ate sugary cereal. They threw tantrums. They cried for no reason. And they broke their stuff on purpose.
Mad eggs do that.
Meanwhile, I tried to take charge. I tried to fix their bad behavior. I tried to keep the peace because I was a good egg. A very good egg. Nobody seemed to care though. Every night I was exhausted. My head felt scrambled. Then, one fateful morning, I noticed some cracks in my shell. They were everywhere. Look at the sign. It says, kick me.
Where is it? Kick me.
My doctor said it was from all the pressure I was putting on myself. The pressure of making sure everybody was as good as me. I was cracking up, literally. Something had to change. I'd had enough. I told Meg and Peg and Greg and Clegg and Shell and Shelly and Sheldon and Shelby and Egbert and Frank and other Frank that I was leaving. I can't be the only good egg in a bad carton, I said. Blah, 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 they replied. I left that night. Aw, look at him. He feels sad.
That's because he has a crack. I mean, and Mom, guess what? He's growing a beard.
Oh my goodness. I wandered from town to town. The hours became days. The days became weeks. I lost track of time. I was alone. Look what he did when he felt alone. Look what he did to the rocks.
He made it friends.
Out there on the road under the stars, I really tried to focus on myself and what
Mom,
I needed.
Guess what? He petted the spiders. And the spider web ball.
I took walks. I read books. I floated in the river. I wrote in my journal. I found simple moments to be quiet. I breathed in. I breathed out. I even started painting. I wonder what you do to take care of yourself. For once, I found time for me. And guess what? Little by little, the cracks in my shell started to heal. My head no longer felt scrambled. He was taking care of himself. I started to feel like myself again. Look, he's meditating. So I've made a big decision. I'm returning to my old carton and my friends. Besides, I'm kind of lonely out there. This time I know what I need to do. I'll try not to worry so much.
Wow, there's a lot of eggs. Mm-hmm.
I'll be good to my fellow eggs while also being good to myself. Here we go. Everybody missed me, and I missed them too. Welcome home. Hello, Meg. Howdy, Peg. Hey, Greg. Greetings, Clegg. What's up, Shell? Aloha, Shelly. Hey-o, Sheldon. Hi, Shelby. Good day, Egbert. What's happening, Frank? Howdy do, other Frank. Sure, every once in a while, somebody's still a little bit bad, but it's not like before. Here's what I realized. The other eggs aren't perfect, and I don't have to be either.
They just go down the stairs with sliding things.
Ooh, does that look dangerous?
No.
Yeah.
Ooh, what does this one look like?
It's
scared or surprised?
Scared.
Happy.
This one is mad.
Happy. Mad. This one?
Mad.
Yay! Those are kind of dangerous things.
Yeah.
Yep, the old carton is back together. We're a solid dozen again. It's good to be home.
The boy like.
The end. Remember, it's good to be... help others make good choices, but also need to take care of yourself. Have a good day.
Bye.
Don't push...